It is an unfortunate development that what is happening, if the federal government have taken proactive steps, today we will not be where we are. These cops you are seeing here, in the last 2 weeks, we are burying over 70 people just in Makurdi local government alone. This is not acceptable. Go to Guman, the same killings are taking place. Go to Gwawas, the same killings are taking place. This is not right. The federal government have refused to take proactive steps to arrest this ugly situation that we're witnessing here today. You will recall that I alerted the entire nation when Fulanis in 14 countries met in Yola and declared that except we repeal the prohibition of open grazing law, Benue will not know peace. And on the ground, I did say that I was targeted for elimination, to be assassinated, and that was done on me. It's only God that saved me. And I did say they are going after my people. So federal government should arrest the leadership of Mayaktiya Lakota and Hore that hosted that meeting. Up to today, nothing has been done. This is really unfortunate. It means we don't have a government in place at the federal level. We don't have a government. This is very sad. Because if proactive steps were taken by arresting Mayaktiya and leadership, this will not happen. For several years, we have been calling on federal government to take proactive steps to address this matter. They have refused to do. You can imagine, this is Abagena IDP camp. They are joining villages here. With the real camp and their adjoining villages are occupied by IDPs. And what else do you want them to do? You send these people away from their villages. They came here to take refuge. And today, they are being killed in this manner. Over 70 people have been killed in the last 2 weeks by this herdsmen. They no longer come with their cattle. They come because they are looking for livestock they are to kill. They have even sent messages that except livestock guard refused to take their cattle so that they will come and graze on our farms. And this we say no, it will not be accepted. What kind of a thing is it? What kind of a country we are in? Mr. President said the other day that the security men should shoot anyone with AK-47. And up to today, we have not heard where security men have shot them. The Minister of Defense came and reversed what Mr. President said, that they said they are arrested and prosecuted. Where are we going? How do you wake up every day and you see your people being killed? How can I be a happy man with this kind of a thing? How can I be a happy man? So please, Mr. President must do the needful. And I want to suggest that immediately let there be a security summit. I'm aware that in Niger, in Zamfara, all over the country, northeast, northwest, north central, southeast, south south, south west, all the places, this kind of barbaric act is being taken by the same Fulanis. And people are afraid to say it. And they give them a name, bandit. They are not bandit, they are Fulanis. These ones that came here, look at the best way that they were seeing, and they were speaking that language. And they came and insisted that they must take government to proscribe or repeal the prohibition of open grazing act. That will not happen. It is not my making. It's the people of Benue State that told me to do that law. I didn't sit on my own and did any law. And so no one should try and make anything. You know? So this is sad. This is sad. This is sad. My heart bleeds. And President Buhari must arise to his responsibility as the commander-in-chief of the armed forces. If he doesn't do it, our people say that the goat doesn't bite. But when you push it to the wall, it will bite. This is not right. This is not accepted. This is not accepted. President Buhari was elected by the people. He must arise and do something. No other person has the responsibility of arming the security men and providing enough equipment and funding to ensure that they eradicate this. This is too sad. Buhari cannot be playing us around because these are Fulani men doing the same thing. As I said, they want to take over our land. If not, what is the excess? You send people away from their farms, and here they are in IDP camp. You come and kill them. What else do you want me to say? Buhari, if you were the governor of Benue, say, what do you want me to say? You must arise and do something to stop it. They are your kinsmen. Call them and tell them this is enough is enough. This is being taking us for granted too far. And this will not be accepted. I know the implication of telling people to go on self-help. And I want to repeat my call that if you are serious on this security matter, Mr. President, allow us to buy AK-47. This is what I said. Give us license so that we too can face them. You have armed your brothers. You have armed your brothers. And you have disarmed us. I saw somewhere where security men arrested those people who had cutlasses, who had sword, who had this thing because they are from Benue State. How about the Fulani men? You know where they are. Go and disarm them. You give an order. Your defense minister will reverse the order. What kind of a thing is that? This is very, very sad. President Buhari, we are not asking you to protect us because we want favor from you. It is your responsibility. You must arise. All this one getting your heads to speak on security matter, it is wrong. You must stand up and address the nation and declare emergency on security. Call a security summit, bring all of us together, and let us agree. And you must be sincere this time, not just playing on us. This is too far. Enough. If you want to kill us, come and kill us. They will know that you were elected to kill all of us. And kill them. We're ready. I'm ready for them. I'm 60 years. I'm ready to go. If you must come and kill us, come and kill us. Come and kill me. Because I cannot be presiding over dead people. This is enough.